It was in 1859 in Washington, D.C., when the crime of passion first entered American public consciousness with the actions of wealthy and respected Congressman Daniel Sickles.
He discovered that his wife was having an affair with Philip Barton Key, who was the son of Francis Scott Key. And he just was so angry about it that he took out his pistols. He planned the murder.
Armed with two pistols and accompanied by his best friend, Sickles confronted Philip Key on the streets of Washington, D.C. He shot him once in the chest, and then, while the wounded man pleaded for mercy, Sickles pumped two more bullets into him. The gunfire was so close to the White House that Sickles' friend, President James Buchanan, heard the shots. Sickles immediately confessed and went to jail. He was charged with first-degree murder, yet a team of top lawyers and several leading politicians agreed to serve as his defense attorneys.
The crux of the defense was temporary insanity. They said it was possible under the law for a person to be temporarily incapable of knowing right from wrong. And after the crime was committed, all of a sudden they know right from wrong again.
The jury acquitted Sickles. The public was more outraged by Sickles' forgiveness and reconciliation with his wife than by the murder and unorthodox acquittal.
He was the first person in American history who successfully defended himself on the grounds of temporary insanity. I think he should have done time and plenty of it for what he did. But you get the feeling that many people feel that this kind of anger is understandable. They can imagine how they might feel if suddenly they were confronted with the fact that their spouse was unfaithful.
The sins of Sickles would have a long-term effect on American law.
In Texas, it was a law for a long time that if you caught your spouse in the act of having sex with someone else, you had the right to shoot that other person. Because their sense was that you would be so justifiably angry and so overwhelmed with rage that any normal person would kill in that circumstance.